Good morning, good morning, good morning. Praise ye the Lord. Praise God in his sanctuary. Praise him in the firmament of his power. Praise him for his mighty acts. Praise him according to his excellent greatness. Let everything that has breath praise ye the Lord. Let us go to God in prayer. Lord, we say thank you, Lord. We say thank you for your grace and your mercy, dear Lord. But we come this morning just to invoke your Holy Spirit among this service, dear Lord. Invoke the Holy Spirit among everybody on the prayer line, dear Lord. Invoke the Holy Spirit to those that are zooming in this morning, dear Lord. And we invoke the Holy Spirit into the presence of our pastor and first lady's home, dear Lord. Bless Caroline in an almighty way. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Good morning again. It's service time, it's worship time, and it's time to begin our morning service and thank God for another day because it could have been another way. When we begin our service this morning with an opening song by our praise team, followed by the announcements by our assistant clerk, Angelina, scripture and prayer by Brother Aaron Athey, followed by a Black History Moment by Sister Madison Gerdo, along with another selection by the praise team. And after that, our pastor will give us some spiritual food for the day. And then he will close in his own way. Wishing each and one of you all to have a blessed day in the Lord.
Muted.
Thank God.
Pastor Tolliver, First Lady, County Line friends and family, good morning. We are moving forward by faith. Sympathy goes out this morning to the family of Sister Daphne Ware Harris, who was funeralized on Saturday. Sympathy also goes out to the family of the late William Qualls Jr. Mr. Qualls was a current member of the Goochland County School Board and a past member of the Goochland Board of Supervisors. Pray much for these families. Please remember to pray for those on our prayer list. This week on our list is Sarah Bradshaw, Willie Bland, George Price, Josephine Timberlake, Adele Qualls, Joanne Price, Yvonne Bryce, Evelyn Mealy, Janet Timberlake, Lucy Payne, Etheline and Joseph Pace, Francis Mitchell, Edward Price, Gilbert Price, Hazel Hughes, Thelma Jackson, Marion Perkins, Johnny and Pauline Payne, Frank Young, Anderson Herndon, Lewis Young, Ianthony Johnson, and Cora McGee. Pray without ceasing. Please remember our worship service is every Sunday at 10 a.m. You may use your Zoom or your prayer line until further notice. Prayer every Wednesday mornings at 7 a.m. on the prayer line. Sunday school every Sunday at 9 a.m. using your prayer line. Tithes and offering. Your trustees are available every Saturday morning from 11 to noon at the church. You may also mail in your tithes and offerings at the P.O. Box 73, Gum Spring, Virginia, or you may send them to the church address, 4030 County Line Road, Kent Store, Virginia. You can also use the church website by using PayPal. Don't forget your missionary offerings, your building fund, and your Sunday school offerings. God so loves a cheerful giver. General information. If you have not received your 2021 church envelopes, please pick them up between 11 and noon on Saturdays. Ask one of the trustees. If you would like your yearly church contributions for tax purposes, please call, text, or email Miss Mary Timberlake. Stay safe for COVID-19. Wear your mask, keep your social distance, take your temperature, wash your hands often. Check the church website under the tab Resources for more information. Anyone needing assistance, registering or pre-registering online with the health department or CVS pharmacy to get vaccinated, please contact Abby Sneed and Reverend Tolliver, who are willing to assist you. February is Heart Health Awareness Month, especially for women. Main cause of health disease, high blood pressure, high cholesterol, smoking, diabetes, unhealthy eating, little to no exercise. Have a health checkup with your doctor regularly. Don't ignore the warning signs. Black History Month. We have come this far by faith. Our journey. Join us on Wednesdays at 7 p.m. beginning February the 3rd for a study of our struggles in recognition of Black History Month. Discussions will focus on the life and legacy of the African Americans from arrival in 1619 to the present day 2021. You may pick up the outline lessons on Saturdays when you drop off your tithes and offerings. Lessons may also be emailed to you. If you'd like the lessons, you can contact Sister Linda Minor. And the lessons are every Wednesday at 7 p.m. Join us for Lent lesson reading. Lent begins Wednesday, February 17th. The book this year is Preparing for Easter, 50 Devotional Readings from C.S. Lewis. Book can be purchased on Amazon. The first meeting is Saturday, February 13th at 5 p.m. to plan and discuss. Use worship and prayer line for contact. Missionary news meetings. Youth missionary will have a meeting Tuesday, February the 9th at 7 p.m. Youth leaders will meet using prayer line at 7. Women's ministry, Saturday, February 27th, from 3 p.m. to 4 p.m., the women's ministry will sponsor virtual bingo. Join us for an afternoon of fun. You can pick up bingo cards Saturday during offering time. Sunday school ministry. All Sunday school teachers are asked to attend a meeting on Monday, February 22nd, for an important discussion. Please use prayer line. Please use the prayer line number. Pastors A-List. Submit your accomplishments to First Lady Tolliver for second marking period and first semesters. Certificates will be given out the 1st of March. Congratulations for all your hard work. Thank you. Thank you to Sister June Athey and her neighbor who donated a box of masks to the church. If anyone needs one, please see the trustees on Saturday when you drop off your offerings. Thank you. Happy birthday and anniversary. Deborah Ware celebrated a birthday on February the 10th. Happy birthday, Deborah. Joseph and Ethelene Pace are celebrating their 71st wedding anniversary on February the 10th. Wonderful. Happy anniversary to the Paces. Anyone else celebrating a birthday or anniversary? Happy birthday, happy anniversary. Have a blessed week. Enjoy the snow.
Good morning. I will be reading out of the book of 1 Corinthians, starting at the 8th chapter, starting at the 13th chapter, 8th verse through the 13th. And it reads, "Love never fails, but whether there are prophecies, they will fail. Whether there are tongues, they will cease. Whether there is knowledge, it will vanish away. For we know in part and we prophesy in part. But when that which is perfect has come, then that which is in part will be done away. When I was a child, I spoke as a child. I understood as a child. I thought as a child. But when I became a man, I put away childish things. For now we see in a mirror dimly, but then face to face. Now I know in part, but then I shall know just as I also am known. And now by the faith, hope, love, these three, but the greatest of these is love." Let us pray. O Lord, how excellent is your name in all the earth. We come to you, thanking you for this day. Thank you for our last night's sleep and the early morning rise. Thank you for blessing us over and over again, although we do not deserve it. Thank you for watching over us in the midst of good and bad, perfect and evil. Thank you for what you've done for us and what you're going to do. Forgive us of our sins and for where we fall short. Cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Dear God, thank you for another Black History Month. Thank you for the forefathers and the men and women who have paved the way for us today. Dear God, for we are not finished yet. Allow us to stay woke in these times of evil. Bless those who are here with us and bless those who have gone on to be with you. Dear Lord, watch over us day by day and bless us, and we shall be blessed. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Muted.
Okay. County Line, my presentation is about an extraordinary actress and fashion model, Miss Cicely Tyson, in a career spanning more than seven decades from 1948 to 2020. She became well known for her portrayal of strong African-American women. Cicely Tyson was born on December 19, 1924 in Harlem, New York. She was the second of three children born to Frederica and William Augustine Tyson, West India immigrants from the Caribbean island of Nevis. At the age 17, Cicely became a mother, giving birth to a daughter, Joanne. In December 1942, at the age of 18, Cicely married Kenneth Franklin. This marriage only lasted 18 months, and they finally divorced in 1956. Later on January 26, 1981, Cicely married the legendary Miles Davis in 1988. During her expensive career, Miss Tyson received numerous nominations and awards to include three Primetime Emmy Awards, four Black Reel Awards, one Tony Award, one Peabody Award, one Screen Actors Guild Award, and Honorary Academy Award, and in 2020, former President Barack Obama presented Cicely to Presidential Medal of Freedom, the highest civilian honor in the United States by the press. One of her acting appearances was in the Diaz family reunion on January 26, 2020, memoir entitled Just As I Am, days before passing away on January 26.
Let's give God a hand clap of praise today. Let's praise him today. Amen. Amen. The Bible reminds us that we're praising from the rising of the sun till it's going down the same. But today we're going to praise him, amen, for the snow. Amen. And that we're able to see the snow. We thank God for all that God is doing. Amen. And we continue to look up to Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith. I'd like to remind you on Saturday, next Saturday at 5 o'clock, we will be reading the book for Lent. Amen. So please turn in. As it'll be a meeting on prayer line and on Zoom. Also, let's give a hand clap to Sister Madison. Amen. Good job for Black History Moment. Amen. Talking about Sister Tyson. Amen. And also, our study on Wednesday night, Black History. Please tune in. I have heard so many comments and so many phone calls about Black History that our facilitator, Ms. Minor, teaching on Wednesday nights is just a blessing. So please tune in on Zoom and on prayer line. Amen. For the Lord is good. Amen. Who looking for better days? I'm too glad to be sad. I'm too cheery to be weary. I'm too serene to be mean. I'm too grateful to be hateful. I'm too blessed to be stressed. I'm too rich to be poor. I'm too happy to be snappy. I feel good, real good, in every way, each and every day. I'm better today than I was yesterday. I'll be better tomorrow than I am today. Give God a 30-second hand praise. Amen, for he is good. Amen. At this time, my brothers and sisters, not going to hold you on very long today, but I'm going to solicit your attention to the Gospel of Mark. Gospel of Mark, Matthew, Mark, New Testament, chapter 14, verses 66 to 72. I've been reading from the New King James Version. Mark chapter 14, verses 66 to 72. The Bible says, verse 66, now as Peter below in the courtyard, one of the servant girls of the high priest came. And when she saw Peter warming himself, she looked at him and said, you were with Jesus of Nazareth. But he denied it, saying, I neither know nor understand what you're saying. And he went out to the porch and a rooster crowed. And the servant girl saw him again and began to say to those who stood by, this is one of them. But he denied it again. And a little later, those who stood by said to Peter again, surely you are the one of them, for you are a Galilean and your speech shows it. Verse 71, now he began to curse and swear, I do not know this man of whom you speak. Our last verse, verse 72. A second time, the rooster crowed. Then Peter called to mind the word that Jesus had said to him. Before the rooster crows twice, you will deny me three times. And he went and he thought about it. He wept. Let us pray. Eternal and everlasting God, I pray that you bless us in this worship service and keep us. Lord, make your face shine upon us and be gracious to us. I pray that we feel your presence during this worship service because you are with us wherever we go. I pray that this worship service focuses upon you and your plans for us as a body of believers. In Jesus' precious, matchless name, we pray. And the people of God said, amen. 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 I like the title of this message today. Sometimes our faith grows weary. Whoever right there in the room with you, look at them and say, sometimes our faith grows weary. My brothers and sisters, Faith is interesting. We know what the Bible says about faith. Faith is the substance of things hoped for and evidence of things not seen. Without faith, it is impossible to please God. Mm-hmm. Webster Dictionary says faith is complete trust or confidence in someone or something. My brothers and sisters, it is easy to say all of these things about faith, but when you have to exercise your faith, that can be a different story.
Yeah.
Faith is easy to explain when you're not experiencing difficulties in your life. Faith is easy when everything is going well in your life and all around you. But when you are faced with trials and troubles and tribulations, turmoil, sickness, and death, and financial need, faith is different.
Yeah.
To be real, all of us have had moments where we had to exercise our faith. Mm-hmm. It wasn't easy. We didn't like it, but some way and somehow God brought us through it.
Yeah.
Somebody's faith is wavering today. The Bible says in James 1 and 6, but let him ask in faith, nothing wavering. Mm-hmm. For he that waver is like a wave in the sea, driven with the wind and tossed. Mm-hmm. Somebody here today is wondering when the difficulties is going to end.
Yeah.
Wondering, will joy come in the morning?
Yeah.
I stopped by to serve notice on the devil today,
mm-hmm.
that I will have unwavering faith in times like these.
Yes.
I know when a pandemic, I know that we have to get vaccinations. I know that the weather is sometimes good, sometimes bad, but I know that we must keep the faith. Faith means that you must trust entirely on God. It means that you trust his time, and even when you're running out of patience.
Yeah.
It means that you must trust his decisions, even if you don't like it.
Mm-hmm.
Here in our text, we see Peter, a disciple of Jesus, who walked with him and ate with him, slept with him, and taught by him.
Yeah.
Watch the miracles that happen, and where he is with his back up against the wall, losing his faith. Sometimes all of us, amen, faith has wavered. Peter's faith began to waver, that he denies even knowing the man called Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
My brothers and sisters, God profiles ordinary people, some with huge character flaws.
Yeah.
I wish I could pop right then.
Mm-hmm.
God can use all of us,
yeah.
because we all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. No one person is better than anyone else. Nobody's so holy than anyone else. Because I always say, if you're so holy and got a halo over your head, just go on up. Amen. And be with the master. God profiles ordinary people, some with huge character flaws, in order to show that he can use the weakest of us to accomplish his purpose,
yeah.
and gain glory for himself. The reason God has us here, it's not about our ABCs on the wall, not about how much money we make, it's not about our titles, but it's to give him glory, praise him for who he is and for what he's done. Like Peter, we make incredible poor choices. Amen. All of us should raise our hand. Like Peter, our poor choices don't have to be the final chapter of our life. My first point is this, my brothers and sisters. Don't let fear take over faith. Tell someone, don't let fear take over faith. In our text in verse 66, we find Peter was below in the courtyard of Caiaphas' house, and one of the servant maid girls of the high priest came. And the Bible says, when she saw Peter warming himself, she looked at him and said, you also were with Jesus of Nazareth.
Mm-hmm.
In other words, she stared at him. By staring at him, identified Peter was one of Jesus' disciples. Maybe she identified Peter because of the type of clothes he was wearing. Maybe she identified Peter because he had been in the crowd with Jesus as Jesus was taught.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe she identified Peter, amen, as one, amen, who had said that he would be with Christ until he died. But all I know, she stared down and called him out. Sometimes in life, you will deal with some issues that you'll be scared.
Yeah.
Peter was afraid to say that he knew Jesus. Mm-hmm. He let fear take over his faith. Mm-hmm. My Lord, fear stands for false evidence appearing real. Mm-hmm. Don't get scared. With God on your side, he will fight for you. Yeah. Don't throw in the towel. My second point is this. Don't miss the opportunity to confess.
Okay.
Confess is to admit or state that one has committed a crime or is at fault in some way. My brothers and sisters, when you confess to God, the Bible says in 1 John 1:9, if we confess our sins, he's faithful and just to forgive us and cleanse us from all unrighteousness.
Yeah.
Instead of Peter confessing that he was with Jesus, the Bible says he denied it, saying neither know or understand what you are saying. He replied back, I don't understand what you're saying. He made some excuses, and we're the same way. We can't knock Peter, amen, because we all have made some excuses, amen. And the servant girl, we see in our text, saw him again and began to say to those who stood by, this is one of them. Peter's fear was building, and instead of leaning on the faith that God would work the situation out, no matter what would happen, Peter denied knowing who God is. Life sometimes will make your problems look bigger than God.
Yeah.
But I stopped by to tell you, they're not. I don't care what you're experiencing today, you must trust totally in God.
Yeah.
There's nothing we'll face in the past, today, or in the future that'll be bigger than God.
Yeah.
Issues might look bigger, feel bigger, but there's nothing or no one bigger than God, because he's the King of Kings and he's the Lord of Lords. There's nothing or no one bigger than God because he's the all-knowing God.
Yeah.
There's nothing no bigger than God because he's the all-present God.
Yeah.
There is nothing no bigger than God because he's the all-powerful God.
Yeah.
There's nothing no bigger than God because he laid down his life for the
yeah.
brethren. There's nothing no bigger than God because he was hung high and stretched wide,
yeah.
went to a cross of Calvary, pierced, bruised, spit at, and everything else. But we thank God for his bigness
yeah.
that he sits on the right hand of the Father and pleading our case every day.
Yeah.
Yes, nothing is too hard for God.
Yeah.
Verse 71 reminds us that Peter feared denied Jesus again. Most of us are like the disciples, because we all are guilty of denying Christ as Lord in certain areas of our lives. If I was at the church right now, I am, I said from pulpit to door. Amen. We all have denied Christ at some time or another. The Bible says, then Peter, verse 71, began to curse and swear, I do not know this man whom you speak. Now we must realize, Peter was one of the original 12 disciples of Jesus, who was well known for his boldness.
Mm-hmm.
Now, you know, Peter was not a scared man, amen. Because Peter was so bold that he'll do anything. He'll slice your ear off if you get him wrong, amen. Peter would, but God knew Peter had some flaws, but God knew he could use Peter. And God did use Peter. God know you got some flaws, but God want to use you. No matter what your flaws, just let God use you just the way you are. Amen. When Peter came back up against the wall, he became afraid and got angry. Peter wrestled between faith and fear. I need to say that again. Peter wrestled against faith and fear. Do you have faith or fear when your back is up against the wall and you feel that you have nowhere to turn?
Mm-hmm.
I stopped by to leave with some good news today. When your back is up against the wall, that Jesus is the author and finisher of our faith.
Mm-hmm.
He will never leave us alone. He is the one who's able to make the mountains move.
Mm-hmm.
Without knowing him, it is impossible for him to move mountains out of your life. Jesus knew Peter, and he knew all about Peter, and he knew all about us. What is wavering your faith this morning?
Yeah.
God knows where there's something in our life will have us to fall on our knees sometimes.
Yeah.
I stopped by to tell you, Don't give in to fear. I know you're tired. I know you're worried, but you must keep the faith, my brothers and sisters. Yeah. Hold on to your faith that God will make it way somehow.
Yes,
he knew where he had messed up, but Peter know that once he get an opportunity to tell somebody but the good news of Jesus Christ, Peter said 3,000 souls got saved.
Yeah.
I don't know what you're doing today, but stop where you're at and tell somebody but the good news of Jesus Christ. But I like what Isaiah said. Isaiah said, don't get worried, because they that wait upon the Lord, he shall renew thy strength. They shall mount up wings of eagles. They shall run and not be worried. And they shall walk and not faint. God doesn't want us to be worried, because God wants us to serve him.
Yeah.
Serve him because he blessed us going in and coming out.
Yeah.
Serve him because he looked beyond our faults and saw our need. Serve him because he made ways out of no way.
Yeah.
Serve him that we don't have to boast for tomorrow, because tomorrow we're going to take care of
self. Yeah.
All we got to do is serve God. We don't have fear, because we know that God is overcoming fear with his power, because he got all power in his hand. I give you some good news this morning. Look up to Jesus, God, and finish up our faith. I give you some good news this morning. Don't let fear stall your faith. God is able, my brothers and sisters. In this message, so many of us get worried because we look around and we see things happening, and we think it's out of our control. And guess what? It is out of our control, because God is in control.
Yeah.
So let God be God, one who's too wise to make a mistake, one who knows everything. I pray that this word encourage you today, amen, that we can run this race a little while longer. Don't get worried. God got it. Let God handle it. He has it, because he has the master plan. He paid for it over 2,000 years ago.
Yeah.
Don't get worried. Allow your faith to continue to work, even in times like these.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Yes. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Yes. Yes.
Change.
Yes.
Change.
Yes. My brothers and sisters, we're in perilous times, but everything we have will pass away, except for our faith. If you trust in God, this faith will take you to eternity, and we'll live forever. Might not be in this fleshly body, but we have a glorified body. But you must keep the faith. All things around you seem like sinking sand, but we know that God is able. He deserved the praise, because even last night, none of us, or any of us, I should say, do not have a roof over our head. All of us still have food on the table. All of us still have clothes on our back. Don't let fear overtake what the doctor said.
Yeah.
Because we know that Jesus is a doctor.
Yeah.
A doctor who's well certified and paid the price be called doctor. We have to change our way of thinking, that we are in a fight. And the fight that we're in, the Bible says that for we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but principalities and power, rule of darkness, spiritual wickedness in high places. If we don't have faith now, we will not make it. If we plan on going to the other side, we plan on fighting for Jesus, we must keep faith. Keep faith alive. It's already been paid for. Is that one? Is that one? The Bible says that God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. Whosoever should believe in him should not perish but have everlasting life. When you have faith, you have everlasting life. All you have to do is just confess the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal Savior. That's good news today. It's just that simple. I know we all have flaws, and I know that we have a history, and I know we messed up. But when Jesus looks at me, he sees that I'm a king. When he looks at you, he sees that you're a queen. I'm going to give God a hand clap of praise myself. Don't worry about how your neighbor look at you, or church folk look at you, but look at how Jesus is looking at you. He said, that's my son and my daughter who I'm well pleased. Oh, there's some great words right there. My son, put your name there. My daughter, put your name there, that whom I'm well pleased. Oh, that's a shout right there. Who I'm well pleased. Yes. Thank you, Jesus. The Bible reminds us that if we're not sure about our salvation, all we have to do is repeat this prayer. The Father God, forgive me of my sins. Come into my heart and save me. If you repeated that prayer, give God a hand clap of praise that you are saved on today. Amen. Let us pray. Gracious and eternal God, Lord, we come now to say thank you. Thank you, God, because you have been our bright and morning star. Thank you, God, that you've been a wheel in the middle of a wheel. Thank you, God, that you've been a rock in a weary land.
Yes.
Thank you, God, that you have fought our battles. Thank you, God, that you have supplied our needs. Thank you, God, that you have delivered us, oh God. Thank you, God, that you have healed us. So God, we just want to say thank you. We're not asking for anything in particular today. We just want to thank you, God, that we don't have to be worried right now because we know that you got it. In Jesus' precious, durable name, we pray. And the people of God said, amen.
Amen.
Then may the love of God and the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit may rest, rule by henceforth and forevermore. We say amen to the Father, amen to the Son, amen to the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
It's camera time.
Amen.
It's camera time. Amen.
Amen.
It's camera time. Get up and give God some praise.
Amen. Y'all turn on those cameras.
It's camera time. Somebody said they ain't got to have dinner. It's camera time.
God bless you all. Y'all have a blessed week. Amen.
Enjoy the Super Bowl.
You have a blessed week as well. Be safe, everyone.
Amen.
Amen.
Move faster. There we go. God bless everyone. Y'all be safe.
Amen.
Be safe.
Get out, everybody.
And everything that's within me, come on, I'm going to bless his name. Is there anybody in this place that is here to bless him? Let me hear your voice of God. Come on, here we go. Say, magnify.
Magnify the Lord with me.
Come on, sing it to him, sing it now.
The sun he has redeemed.
Come on, say, clap your hands.
And your hands rejoice at me.
Oh, man.